sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, you rockin' that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walk a flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you want to do is talk on.
Making industry music, they want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That ticket, he talking big hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's, only the thousand, boy. I let it get too touch, and it get too foul, boy. I'm talking, you out of bounds, boy. Please don't test me like I'm that boy Danny. And ain't talking dang. It's like everything look cut them jaw. They go insane, they wanna pitch. Ain't gon' get in the beef, I'ma just make them blitz. Round 4 deep in the sprinter. How that's your girl, and she in my rental. We had cable, we ain't even have no tunnels. They change the tunnel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, B&E. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. That's my sweet, but I be switching it depending on the week. Christian Lou, red bottom, them I think I. They talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gonna count to y'all.
Today, from Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin, this is Madden Football on EA Sports. And the Green Bay Packers taking on Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons.
There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. No run back here on the opening kickoff as we'll start at the 25. Atlanta takes the field. Their offensive leader, of course, Matt Ryan, the former Boston College Eagle.
And when you start with listing a guy's accomplishments like Matt Ryan's, all these years in the league, near the top of the league in completions and percentage, touchdowns each and every year, has won an MVP, taken his team to the Super Bowl. You're talking about a guy who might be finished, but he still has gas left in the tank. Big right arm, great leader, the face of his franchise.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. To throw is Ryan. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Get this only up to about the 35. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
On third down, Patterson. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
First down, Ryan. He's got his pass-catching tight end. That's Pitts. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Back-to-back 11-yard gains, and they've got another first down. Now Ryan. This is to Pitts on the quick slant. Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on their perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
Now a quick slant as the throw's complete, and this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 18. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sidelines thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On third down, Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And his kick is good. And the Falcons are out to a 3-0 advantage. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. Veteran Green Bay quarterback Aaron Rodgers ready to go for drive number 1 along with the rest of this Packer offense.
I remember watching him in college and seeing a guy that you knew had great potential, but I don't know that anyone knew that we would see how he would blossom as an NFL player who will go down as one of the all-time great quarterbacks. Can make every throw from every angle with terrific mobility, and he knows how to win games, always in contention for a championship.
Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
The job of any linebacker involves having enough strength to fight off a blocker and get to ball carriers. But in this case, I think we can safely say he beat him right off the snap to get into the backfield and make that play.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together, a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Man open, that's Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10, right at the 40. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
And just a yard to go here on second down. On play action, it's Rodgers. Leaping, and he makes the grab. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Here's a give to Jones running left. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. And it's a Packers touchdown. Rodgers finding Valdes-Scantling. And the Packers have taken the lead. Certainly there are good things about quick strike offenses that score fast. But a long drive can also work to your advantage as well.
In so many ways, Brandon. Because number one, you get them tired. But the big one is mentally. They can't figure out how to slow you down, how to get off the field, how to get the ball back. They go to the bench wondering, what are we going to do next time in order to stop those guys?
Crosby connects on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. So that drive in total 8 plays, and it ends with a Packers touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And Patterson not going to return this. It'll come out to the 25. So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. From the shotgun, Ryan. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. From midfield now, here's Ryan. Got this complete to the tight end Pitts. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 39. Here's Patterson. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Here's Ryan to throw. And he's going to have the hook up to Gage. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3 our score. You in just a couple of minutes. We'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football so far. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 13-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, first and 10. Throw over the middle, going to be caught here by Pitts. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second and 5. From the gun, it's Ryan. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play.
He decided to run a hitch route. Really helped out. The guy can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on 3rd and 2. Throwing again, Ryan. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Green Bay up to the task there in coverage and forcing a 4th down.
Well, it's been a tough go for him. This guy's been driving down the field, but defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure. That's going to lead to a 4th down. Well played.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2. They'll run for it with Davis. And nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped behind the line. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. And they've now made 2 trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in, and if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, if you're in the red zone, we're thinking we're giving up 3. We just want to give up 6. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
On play action, now Rodgers, looking deep for Adams. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. A give to Jones. First down and much more here for Jones. And they will finally get him down at the 28. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
Now they contend with a 2nd and 12 after the loss. To throw is Rodgers. He's going to go for a big play downfield. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now a play fake. Rodgers. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. His guys have the lead as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. And the Packers ready to go to start quarter number 3. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides, and there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
They'll try again from the 20 on second and 10. Rodgers going to give this one to Dillon. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead, because they are leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. They'll try the left side with Dillon. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
On first down, Rodgers looking deep for Adams. And that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. A big play there, Rodgers to Adams, 46 yards.
They came out with an aggressive mindset to start the third quarter, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them take more of these type of deep shots as this game moves along. They connected there. They expect to connect on more before this one's over.
They'll run here with Dillon. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. A.J. Dillon, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Packers take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point try now for Crosby. It's up and good, and that makes it 17-3. That drive goes 80 yards in 6 plays. And it was A.J. Dillon who capped it off with a touchdown run. for the touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. No return here for Patterson, so they'll begin things at the 25-yard line. So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender. From there, he doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Crosby for the point after. And the lead now to three touchdowns and 21 points. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And Patterson will not return it. It comes out to the 25. Atlanta prepped and ready for its next possession. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount. Here's his opportunity.
It all comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And he's got him. Got his man on the end route. Complete. Touchdown! Russell Gage, 63 yards. And the Falcons cut into that lead. Early on, you hit on it. Needing to avoid the big play. Easier said than done, though. There's a big touchdown.
Yeah, the big thing is when he does get his catches, you've got to tackle him and get him on the ground. Obviously, weren't able to do it on that one.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And the lead will be cut down to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Grady Jarrett, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9.
They were trying to set up a screen there, but that one just too slow in developing.
Yeah, too slow in developing and well read, because that ends up being a bad feeling for the quarterback. When he's got no blocking in front of him, his guys are just going to let defenders go, and they're coming for him. So if it's not there, you just got to throw the ball at the turf at your running back's feet. Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
It's caught here by Adams. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off. I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available, because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. 41 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Rodgers now to throw.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
On third down, here's Jones. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Now they try the right side here. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Now a handoff. Running left is Jones. 7 yards on the carry. Make it third and four coming up.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And Crosby puts it through, and that'll push the lead up to 17.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a three-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But, you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, two scores is tough enough. Three, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
And Patterson not going to return this. It'll come out to the 25.
Atlanta now coming out on the field.
And the complexion of this one has really changed a fair amount. That last field goal makes it a three-score game, so they need points in a hurry with time dwindling in the fourth quarter.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive, Ryan. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. Oh, he sheds himself free. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan.
Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. There he goes, right side. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And the lead is now 24. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. No return here for Patterson, so they'll begin things at the 25-yard line. Atlanta regains possession of the football. And that last pick six may have been the backbreaker as they now face a three-score deficit in the fourth quarter. They need points quickly. Ryan to the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They're going to start to drive here on the ground with Patterson. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
From the 29, Ryan. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big connection on that one, 30 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Ryan. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And finally marked down at the 23. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat. At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Throwing again on second and 10, Ryan. That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call.
Hey, you don't need no more penalties right here.
So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey.
And yet again, Ryan is intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what are you doing when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
Now Crosby for the point after. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six, they'll get another shot at it now, as this one's in the air. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. Ryan will bring the Falcons up now first and 10 at their own 25. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And into the end zone, it's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. The
those free safeties. They get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
Extra point up and good by Crosby, and that will extend this big lead. They'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And Patterson will not return it. It comes out to the 25. And here now come the Falcons. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Now here's a throw that's taken in by Tajay Sharp. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven. Past the 30 to the 32. Second down and three. Now it's Ryan. That's complete to Sharp. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first and 10, it's Ryan. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Jair Alexander. Then they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. They'll wind up losing eight on the sack there, and it's second down. They'll try and run some clock now with Jones. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Open man left side. It's the tight end, Tonyan. And a tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. They'll go with Jones. Runs over him. And he's taken down inside the 30. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Rodgers throwing here. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. 5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on third down. Rodgers going to throw. He goes right back to Adams. That's complete. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, the incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, this is long since over, and some might see this as overkill, but remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes, and that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. That time, a 9-play drive. And the result, a Green Bay score. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away.
And Patterson not going to return this. It'll come out to the 25.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Packers are winners here as we say so long from Lambeau.